Attorney General McCasey, what was the justification for keeping reporter Judith Stern in jail for 85 days when the source of the leak was known to be Deputy Attorney General Richard Armitage?
Well, as you know, I was not on duty when that case came to the fore, and it's my own view that that case may very well be a better argument against the special counsel than it is in favor of legislation of the sort that's been proposed. I think.
Well, I'm not prepared to deal with the special counsel because he's not here. If I had Senator Leahy's gavel, I would have brought him in here a while ago once the case was finished. But it's very germane in evaluating public policy on whether the Department of Justice ought to have the authority to issue a subpoena in the context and move for a contempt citation and hold a reporter in jail for 85 days under very unpleasant circumstances. I can attest to that firsthand. I went to visit her.
There's no such thing as jail under pleasant circumstances. It is an inherent contradiction, and is something that, therefore, we use as a last resort and will continue to use as a last resort.
Well, why do you need a resort when you know the leak? When you know who the leaker is, why go after a reporter and keep her in jail?
As I said,
now, I know that would be better addressed to the special counsel.
Someday
we may have an opportunity to do that, but right now, you're all we've got, Attorney General McCasey, and you're the guy who's pushing the policy. So I think it's a fair question to say to you, why maintain a policy which gives whoever the prosecutor is the power to do that when you know who the leaker is?
We don't give that power to a prosecutor for precisely that reason. We require a clearance up through and including the Attorney General of the United States.
Attorney General of the United States is a prosecutor. My time is up, and I will desist. We will revisit these issues, doubtless. I just want to say I have